Hello, and welcome to the Cool Science Virtual Art Exhibition Celebration for Merrimack Valley participants. Please join us in recognizing the work of our elementary school honorees. Runner-up.
My name is Aylin Cray. I'm in second grade. I am a homeschool student. I live in Middleborough, Mass. My artist statement, keep me cool in a heat wave. In a heat wave, I like to have ice cold lemonade and go in the pool. I hope others looking at my picture will also find ways to keep cool in a heat wave.
Runner-up.
Hi, my name is Cora Hogan. I'm in fourth grade. I live in Whitman, Massachusetts. I go to Louise A. Conley Elementary School. To stay warm during a blizzard, you should get warm clothes and warm pajamas. You might want to get a couple of blankets. You should drink hot coffee and hot chocolate. If you go outside, then you should put on a warm coat and snow pants. Also, you should put on a hat, scarf, and mittens. What I want people to learn from my artwork is that you should always dress appropriately for the weather, and that you should dress warm during a blizzard and cold weather. I created my work the way I did because I want people to know that if you go outside during a blizzard, then you should wear a hat, mittens, and scarf. And if you are inside, then you should wear a sweater. It also helps to eat and drink warm foods and drinks. The competition inspired me to put bright colors into my work so you can see it from 5 feet away as it says in the guidelines. From making the book and the poster, I learned a lot. I learned how a thunderstorm forms and how to prepare for a hurricane, a blizzard, and a tornado. My experience was amazing doing the poster and book. I am very glad I did it, and I hope you enjoy my work.
Runner-up.
Darren Clemesh, fourth grade, Western Massachusetts, Normandy Day Elementary School. The name of my artwork is called The Shield. My artwork is about how to control the flow of water to avoid floods. We need to be smart about how we use dams and levees, also embankments, metering rivers help slow down the floods. We're trying to get our community prepared for extreme floods. It starts at the mountain, through the town, and through the city. I wanted to show the journey of the river so I can show the defense in this town it passed and how we protected them and the community. The art materials I used are Sharpie and oil pastels. I think what people will learn from this artwork is that floods can be more dangerous than you think, and we should be careful and cautious about floods. I learned about meandering, embankments, and more about floods. What inspired me to do this question is that my grandma's hometown was getting a lot of floods, and I wanted to help her. So I drew a drawing so she can get less floods. I think if someone starts a community, they should have these measures. If they do not, they might end up having to spend a lot of money for the damage every flood does. But if they do, this can be a huge help to them. Maybe you can send ideas to your mayor to protect your community from flooding.
Runner-up.
Soria Suan, 4th grade, Chelmsford, South Row Elementary School. My name is Soria Suan, and I am 10 years old. I chose the question, how do severe storms form? I chose this question because I am interested in storms. My picture is about how tornadoes form. What inspired me is my little brother, because he is also interested in tornadoes and always asks about them. A detail that you can't see in the picture is that a thunderstorm and a tornado forms at the same place and time.
Runner-up.
My name is Annabelle Schneider. I'm in fifth grade, and I live in Somerville, Massachusetts, and I go to the John F. Kennedy School. The reason I created this piece is because I want people to know you can cool down by going to the beach, and you should ride your bike to get there. You should ride your bike to decrease the carbon footprint and reduce greenhouse gases. Climate change makes summers hotter than winters harsher. During the heat of the summer, you can cool off and go to the ocean. When you ride your bike, it's a win-win for you and the planet. If you suffer from that scorching heat, don't make it worse by driving your car. Your car will just make the world hotter. Something I hope people will learn from my artwork is that you have to make a change. Everyone's little part counts. If everyone rode their bike to the store, park, or library instead of driving, the world's greenhouse gases would be reduced by a lot. Do your part to stop climate change, and don't sit back and think I'll let other people do it, because those other people include you when they say others say it.
Winner.
Hi, My name is Zoya Fatan. I am in third grade, and I live in Lowell, Massachusetts. The name of my school is the Islamic Academy for Peace, and my artist statement goes like this. A thunderstorm is an example of extreme weather. I addressed my challenge question, how severe storms are formed, by showing how a thunderstorm is formed. I'm showing how warm, moist air mixes with cool, dry air, forming unstable air. When the unstable air is disturbed, it starts to rise. As the unstable air gets higher, a cloud starts to form. It gets bigger and bigger. And soon, when the cloud is full of water, the rain starts coming down. Happy spring showers. Then, cool, dry air flows out of the cloud in a downdraft, while warm, moist air flows into the cloud in an updraft. This builds up an electric charge in the cloud, causing lightning and thunder. Thunder is caused when lightning strikes the ground, causing the air around it to warm up and expand rapidly. Through my artwork, I would like the people of Massachusetts to become aware of this wonderful phenomenon in nature. The art competition encouraged me to use my art materials in a new and unique way. I hope people will get a good understanding of how thunderstorms form. I learned how thunder and lightning are caused, and I also realized the importance of it as it brings rain showers. The process of the water cycle that I learned in my school inspired me to do this artwork on thunderstorms. Thank you.
Winner:
Annalise Philpott, Grade 6, Westford, Stony Brook. I answered my challenge question, how does severe weather form, by making a diagram on how a tornado forms so we can watch out for signs of tornadoes. A tornado is a vertical column of air that rotates around a low pressure center called a core. The air around the tornado wants to get into the low pressure zone, causing the vacuum of a tornado. A tornado can form when winds blow in different directions at different altitudes, typically 5,000 feet, called a wind shear. This creates a horizontal cylinder that rotates by the wind blowing it. The wind cylinder gets pushed up by air rising from below, which pushes it upwards until it splits, the two parts joining together to make a vertical cylinder. After a while, the cylinder grows into a huge rotating storm called a supercell. A supercell is a gigantic storm. They usually produce large amounts of hail, extreme rainfall, and lightning. Although the lightning generally stays in the clouds, there is around a 30% chance that a supercell will produce a tornado. When a supercell's bottom touches the ground, the bit that touched the ground turns into a tornado. I added flying debris and broken cars and houses to show how destructive a severe tornado can be, because I think people should know how dangerous a tornado can be and how to watch out for them. As long as we stay educated and prepared, we can lessen the injuries each year caused by severe storms.